the one for all of us now. He's the one that we lost.
I'm still pissed off that he's not here because we haven't finished our chapters yet, and it's not right.
Who, Jeff Wheeler?
How do you describe a guy like Jeff?
When I think of Jeff, I remember him always smiling, always very positive, always saying a hello.
He was fearless in terms of making sure you enjoyed life. He enjoyed life. Everyone around him enjoyed life and smiled.
I would say he had it all, even then, because you knew he was smart, but he wasn't a geek by no means. He had charisma. He had it all.
Jeff was awesome. Jeff was the guy that dated all the cute girls and was just perfect.
When I think about him, I can only think of him smiling, and he made you feel like you were the only person around. Even at the reunion 2 years ago, when I was talking to him, he made me feel like I was the only thing that was important at that time.
Every time I saw him, he was always extremely sincere and always happy to see me. And I think that goes for everybody. Just all that, constantly happy, super positive.
He was a happy guy. You know, there wasn't a day that we didn't do something and he wasn't laughing or I wasn't laughing, which is a great thing to remember about him. And if I close my eyes and I think about Jeff, I can always see that smile and that crazy laugh of his.
But he was always kind, always fun, smart guy.
He was brilliant and magnetic and charming, smart and funny.
Always with a smile on his face. Never being malicious to anyone, ever. Always such a good heart for everybody and always like helping everybody else.
Great guy, great smile, loved to have fun and loved life and wanted to live it to the fullest.
All of us, boys, girls, everybody just wanted to hang with Jeff, right? You just wanted to be around his positive energy and his smile and his kindness.
The most likable guy you could ever imagine, very calm, always controlled, and always, you know, there to help people and you know, be a really best friend for anybody that needed it.
I can remember having lots of fun with Jeff, being up way too late at night and having things to do the next day, and it wouldn't matter if you saw the sun come up. He would be up working schoolwork. He was always on the honor roll, no matter how crazy he was the night before and the things he did. And he was a driven person. He was determined, and he deserved, you know, everything he had because he worked hard. He was a hard worker, for sure.
If you needed him, he was there. And if you were distraught about something, he would say, no, talk to me.
He never seemed to get angry or bitter, he was never small or mean. And in high school, that's something.
Just, he was always a good guy. Like, I mean, just sort of the gel sort of that held everybody together, right? Like,
wasn't one to sit still. Always moving, always something on the go.
He was a businessman, and he was very good at what he did, but he really had a heart, and he was a kind soul, and really, he was a friend of everybody. But when it came to business, Jeff was all business.
The neat thing with him, though, is that you always knew that he was interested in you. It didn't matter if you were a jock, or a prep, or a geek, and I happened to be in the geek squad. But, you know, so often there might have been a clique in the school, and Jeff seemed to hang with them all.
He was just one of those guys that you liked, that instantly there was a friendship there, and he was wonderful.
The kind of guy everybody would want to know. He was always friends with everybody. He was very, very friendly, could make friends, you know, so easily. And he always had a smile on his face.
Whether you were the football player, the athlete, the smart kid, not the smartest kid, you're a little bit tall, a little bit short, a little bit plump, it didn't matter. He just liked everybody.
Yeah, he could transcend all those groups and just make everyone feel like they're the most important thing in the room at the time.
And it didn't matter how popular he was with the in crowd, he was always kind and generous with everyone. It didn't matter if you were, you know, the most popular person or someone that might not have been so popular. So he had a great warm heart that way, for sure.
And he knew how to have the best time, and you gotta love his fearlessness and his courage to take chances and take risks and live life to the fullest.
What I remember most was Jeff's smile. It didn't matter how tense situations were, even at school, Jeff found a way to make others smile. And I remember my oldest daughter saying, "Dad, his smile was infectious in his class." So Jeff's smile told it all. And I'm sure he's smiling down on all his friends today.
Just one of those genuine people that missed sadly, but remembered so happily and fondly and loved, so well loved.
That's the kind of guy Jeff was.
I was 8 years old and running with a dime in my hand to the bus stop to pick up a paper from my old man. Sit on his lap, that big old Buick steer as we drove through town. Tassel my hair, say some, take good look around. This is your hometown. This is your hometown. This is your hometown. This is your hometown.
We went to school together at St. John's. We went to school together at St. James, and we went to school together at Bishop Macdonell. And it got funner and funner and funner as the years went on, so it was pretty fantastic.
I remember when we were in the SRA, the Student Representative Assembly, he was the main organizer of things that were just barely legal.
On the Student Council at Bishop Macdonell, I was the Vice President, Mark was the President, Jeff was Treasurer, you guessed it. Treasurer, looking after the money. We had huge success that year financially. We did really well for the school. We had tons of fun, and we had a key to the SRA office. The SRA office is a special room only where the five men of the school student council could go to. It was in the basement of BM. And when you have give five high school boys a key to a room where only they can go, it can get crazy. So we brought in tools, we had to retrofit the SRA office, and at the back of the office there was urinals, and because it used to be a locker room, so urinals, like we can't have that. So Jeff and I and the rest of the guys, we built a fireplace. So we put a fireplace over top of the urinals, and then we put a trap door in the fireplace so we could hide stuff in the fireplace and move it in and out.
The grade 12 camping trip was amazing, and I got to talk to him more so than I did at school because I wasn't really part of that whole crowd. And you know, like when you guys went into the water and you were freezing your butts off and coming out and Jeff having like a towel this big and like, "I'm so cold, but that was so cool." Like not even complaining about the fact that he was cold. And then he was like, "Okay, let's get a campsite going." And then he was always like, "Let's get everything going." And it was so amazing about him. Like no matter if you're feeling crappy or he'd always get you going.
What was the Meatloaf song? Yeah, going to the edge, it's the Bad Out of Hell album. But anyhow, I always remember him. I always remember him doing his little hops. Skip dance, and when that song came on, the bellowing at the top of your lungs singing that song, and it was always at the dances at BM. Like, just so frozen moment in time.